Good morning, everyone. I hope all of you are good and safe at home. So, in the last part of the video, we had discussed about your terrestrial habitats. Okay, we had completed your terrestrial habitat. Okay, we came to learn about different types of plants which grow in different types of terrestrial habitat. Today, we will start our next topic, that is your aquatic plants. Okay, aquatic means water, plants which grow in water. That is known as your aquatic plants. So let's start. So your aquatic plants are of three types. Okay, your floating, fixed, and underwater plants. Okay, so let's discuss it one by one. So your aquatic plants are of three types. Okay, that is your floating plants, your fixed plant, and your underwater plant. Okay. So you have floating plants. What are the floating plants? Floating plants means freely float in water, which can freely float in water. Okay, like your duckweed, water hyacinth, and water lettuce. Okay, you know these aquatic plants have a waxy coating on its surface, which prevent them from decaying in the water. Okay, so here, this is a duckweed plant, which you will find in the water. This is a water lettuce, which you find in the water. Okay, you know these plants are spongy and filled with air, and this make them light and help them to float in water. And you know they have stomata for the exchange of gases with the air. And one more thing, these plants protect small animals from sun heat. So these are all about your floating plants. Okay, they have their bodies are spongy and are filled with air so that they can easily float in water. So that is their adaptation, that is the special feature which help them to survive in the water. Now, so next is your fixed plants. Fixed means those aquatic plants which have roots fixed at the bottom of the water bed in the mud. Okay, like I'm showing you the picture of a fixed plant. Okay, so here is the picture of a plant which is the example of a fixed plant. So you can see that the roots of these plant are fixed in the mud. Okay, that's why they are known as your fixed plant. Now let us see that the special features which help them to adopt or which help them to survive in these conditions. So an example of your fixed plant is water lily. So you know you can see here the leaves of these plant are broad and flat. Why they are broad and flat? So has to get sufficient air and sunlight so that they get sufficient air and sunlight. And you know their stems are hollow and flexible. They have flexible stem that bend with the flow of water so that they are not affected by strong water current. Okay, the upper surface of leaves have stomata. On the upper surface of the leaves, they have stomata, and stomata help them in the exchange of gases. Okay, your lotus plant and water lilies are the examples of your fixed plant. Okay, this is your lotus plant. Okay, so their special features are they have broad leaves which that's why they get sufficient air and sunlight. Their stems are hollow and flexible that bend with the flow of water. As the flow of water, they bend at that side. Okay, and you know their upper surface of the leaves have stomata which help in the exchange of gases. And examples are your lotus and water lilies. Okay, now your next part is underwater plants which remain completely under the water. Okay, as before we had discussed about your fixed plant whose roots are only fixed at the bottom of the water bed in the mud. And before that we had discussed about your
we had discussed about your floating plants, okay, which float on the surface of water. Now come to your underwater plants. Plants which remains completely under the water. Okay, they are also known as your submerged water. Like examples are hydrilla and tape grass. Okay, here you can see the picture of hydrilla. These plants always remain under the water. Okay, now let us see that what features help them to remain under the water. Okay, first is your roots of these plant are fixed in the soil under the water. Okay, as in the fixed plant, roots are fixed in the root are fixed at the bottom of water bed in the mud. Like this, roots of underwater plants are fixed in the soil under the water, and they have flexible stem like your fixed plant. Next is, you know, they do not have stomata. The leaves of these plants do not have stomata. Now they do not have stomata, then how they can breathe? They breathe through the small air spaces present in their stem. You can see in their stem there are small air spaces through which they breathe. Okay, they do not have stomata. These plants breathe in carbon dioxide. They breathe in carbon dioxide given out by aquatic animals such as fishes and turtles, and they help to clean the air around them. So that is all about your underwater plant. Okay, they have fixed root in the soil, they have flexible stem, they breathe through the small air spaces present in their stem, and they breathe in carbon dioxide which is given out by the aquatic animal, and they clean the air around them. So that's all about your underwater.
They are free floating plants, fixed plants, and underwater plants. The water hyacinth and duckweed are examples of free floating plants. These plants are not fixed to the soil. They float freely on water. Stems and leaves of these plants are light and spongy. This helps the plant float freely on water. The water lily and lotus are fixed plants. These plants have their roots fixed in the soil at the bottom of a pond. They have a thin, long, hollow, and flexible stem to reach the surface of water and withstand water currents. Their leaves are broad and flat, which helps them float on water. The leaves are covered with a waxy coating. This prevents the leaves from rotting. The leaves have small pores called stomata only on their upper surface, so that water does not block the pores. The flowers are large and bright, which help them float and attract pollinators, respectively. The tape grass and pondweed are examples of underwater plants. These plants grow completely underwater and are not visible above the surface of water. Their roots are fixed to the soil at the bottom of a water body. They have thin, narrow leaves to withstand water currents, and the leaves do not have any stomata. These plants breathe through their body surface.
I hope all of you have watched the video carefully. So today what we had discussed, we have discussed about your different types of aquatic habitat. Aquatic habitat are of three types. Okay, you're fixed, you're floating, and underwater. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.